Very good morning, students. I, Asad Patel, welcome you to study from home. Today, I am going to recapitulation of chapter number 10, Walls Tell Stories. In a previous chapter, I explained you that some of children went picnic, okay, at Golconda Fort with his Didi, means with their Didi means their elder sister, and their Didi, their elder sister, is a student of history. So as a student of history, she explained all the things about the Golconda Fort to the children. Okay, now in a previous class we learned that fort is a place which is surrounded by thick and large wall on all side, okay, to protect the town or to protect the people. And in fort people live and work, okay. For example, in a fort you would find king, okay, ruler, nobles, okay, craft person, artisan, business person, trader, farmer, and common civilian. Okay, this Golconda fort is fort had a burz, okay, basins, okay, with hole. Now this basins give a clear picture of outside, right? So this burz or this basins help or make able to soldiers to protect their fort, their territory, okay. The purpose of thick and large wall, okay, as I told you, fort is made up of a thick and large wall, okay. So why they construct thick and large or tall wall? Just because to protect, they want to prevent outsider, they want to stop outsider or enemy, okay, to enter the town, right? For that purpose they construct a huge large and tall wall, as well as they, you know, attach or they construct basins, means burz. So burz make soldiers or able soldier to see the enemy or outsider, and they can attack outsider or enemy easily, right? They hide inside the basins and see through this hole. Fort is not only made up of large wall and burj basins, but it is also, you know, well planned house, okay, well planned water supply system, well planned drainage system, well planned city, okay, right? So fort is a well planned town, okay, well planned fortified town, right? You would find, you know, good supply of water. For example, like, you know, you can see fountain. Even today, student, we construct a place, we construct a wall on which you would find dampness, or sometime you would find crack, okay, after 2 to 3 years. But during those days, the construction was too solid, too strong, okay? So you won't find any dampness, or you won't find any, you know, crack, right? And you can see fountain system in the fort. So how they supply water, right? For example, let's talk about today. If you want to supply water on second or third floor, you need a electric motor pump, okay, electric motor to supply water at third floor. But how they supply water at first or second floor? Because you would find fountain on second floor. So how they supply? They have a huge tank that create a pressure, and through and they supply water with pipe, and just because of that pressure, fountain could get water, right? Student, not only you know they are very good in a construction, an architect, but they are also very sharp and very you know clever to find direction without compass, right? In those days, these days we have Google Map, GPS system, means global positioning system. We have a compass, we have an electronic map to locate places. But in those days, they don't have, neither they have compass nor they have a GPS system or electronic gadget. But they locate direction with sun. Okay, they face this where the sun rise. Okay, and then this is how they find out the directions. So then this is a picture, this is map of Golconda Fort, where you can find darwaza, different darwaza, means different gate. But these gate were very huge. Why they construct such a huge gate? Because they could allow group of people at the same time. That's why they construct huge gate, right? You can find student, these are the gun storage. Okay, there are so many gun storage. Okay, why they require this gun storage? As I explained you in my two previous classes, that that was a time of war. Okay, one king try to conquer or try to capture other king's area or other king's territory, okay, to expand his kingdom. That's why to protect themselves against the other king or against the outsider, they have this gun store. Okay, they have bauli, means step well. Now let me show some step well. Okay, this step well are constructed in different area. Why? To supply water, okay, to the people. Okay, and hose, this is hose. Hose is a big tank which is dug on floor, okay, on land. Okay, to store the water where they can, you know, where people can take a bath, or they can use water from the hodge. As well as darwaza, I told you, darwaza, huge gate. Now, road. See, this is road, okay? It indicate that this road, they use this road, okay, to supply things, okay, or to visit one place to another place, means they have well planned road. Okay, places, they also construct a garden, okay, where people can go and you know get some enjoyment or for leisure. They construct bag. Student, this was a time of war. Okay, so they need to communicate with one another. Okay, now how they communicate? because these days we have mobile phone, wireless, SMS, WhatsApp, internet. Okay, in short, we have a telecommunication. Now, in those days, how people communicate with other in a time of emergency like war and all? They have a rod, okay? They have an ecosystem. You can hear your voice one or two times. That is called ecosystem. So they use ecosystem, right, to communicate with each other. Arrangement of water. As I told you, they supply water from one place to another place and with pipes, and they keep big tank, okay, to store water, bowli, hodge. Now you can observe this picture. This is Persian wheel, right? They pull out water from the ground through this Persian wheel, right? You can see pipe. These are some pipe, okay, to supply water, and to get the water they use a Persian wheel, okay? From ground they pull out water with the Persian wheel. We these days we have a motor, okay, electronic motor to pull out water. Now these forts were very strong and solid, okay, that they can survive for 500 to 600 years, okay. Not only fort, but a construction of a Mughal era, Mughal period, which survive even these days. We have a, you know, very old mosque in Lal Bazar, Bharuj, Jama Masjid, which is I guess 1000 or 900 years old. So what a sad sight. Now why sad sight? Because, you know, we are not take good care of our historical monuments, because these historical monuments are our past. We can learn so many things, okay, from the past. Even then, even though we are not take good care of our past, our buildings, you can see, you know, some people write their name on walls and spoil the wall with spray color or with charcoal or with color, right? So this is how this the beauty of that place is ruined, okay? Now going to museum. Now what is museum? Museum is a place where past remain or old things can be as stored, okay? We can keep old things and old material or past remain inside the museum. So then we also can make our own museum. How? For example, we can keep discontinued things, means discontinued currency like note of 1000 rupees, note of 500 rupees, old 500 rupees, right? We can keep, you know, old currency like 10 paisa, 50 paisa, we also can keep, you know, old tickets of post. We can keep postcard, inland letter. These all things are, you know, discontinued. Postcard, even these days people use postcard, but very less, very few people. That was not, you know, discontinued, but people won't generally use this postcard, right? You can see, you know, old materials. If you want to, you know, see the old thing, you know, old material, past remain, you have to visit museum where you can find, you know, so many beautiful art and craft. Look at the painting and tell. This painting is a 500 years old. It shows a Agra fort being constructed, right? How fort is being constructed? For example, this person is breaking the stone, this bring material, this person supply stones, okay, fine stone. This must be an engineer who guide them how to, you know, put the things or how to construct. This person bring water with his mashak. Okay, now what is mashak? Mashak is a made up of a leather, which is leather bag. Generally people used to carry water in mashak, right? When they travel from one to another place, they keep water in the mashak. Nowadays you won't find any mashak, as we have, you know, plastic bottles, right? So these days no one use mashak, right? So student, this is all about the chapter. Okay, thank you.